Good evening to one and all present here. I am very thankful to IEEE Sensor for giving this opportunity. Myself Sridhar, PhD scholar doing research under the guidance of Dr. Ramachandraiah, the professor and head electrical sciences from Hindustan Institute of Technology and Science, Chennai. I am very thankful to Hindustan Institute for supporting and giving this opportunity. To do research and present the research titled Identification of Eye Blink Artifact Using Wireless EEG Headset for Brain Computer Interface System. My presentation, the flow will be in this way: introduction, challenges, motivation, and so on. Before explain about the research work, just I will briefly explain how the brain works. This I have shown the structure of neuron. Whenever the intention of a subject will come outside, it is because of the neuron activation. That's we will call it as in a neuron firing. It will happen. This is in the right side of your side. It will see this threshold value under this mind is 70 millivolts. This all happens in the membrane where the channels which is present on the sodium and potassium channels, when it is going to open, then the sodium ions which will be enter, and these differences will leads to get the action potential. And at the same way, if there is no stimulation, then at the same time what will happen is the repolarization, which is mentioned as 3, then the potassium ions come out, and at this one, when it is going to hyperpolarization, then again it will try to come to the resting state. These are the different lobes present in our brain. We'll call it as frontal lobe, parietal, occipital, and the temporal lobe. And each and one having this their own functions, such as for motor functions and sense and the occipital, the vision, everything we can see in these lobes. I'm not going in depth about these things. And this slide explains that placement of electrodes and how it names it as EEG, which we are called as electroencephalography, in which the electrodes are placed on the scalp, whereas it is non-invasive. And the B, that is, which is under the dura mater, which is called electrocorticography, which is invasive. And intracortical neuron recording, which is placed under the dura mater or the brain layer, which is white layer, will be there. There we are going to place the electrodes. Here the a brain computer interface. Now I am going to come and brief about the research work. Brain computer interface is a direct communication pathway between the brain and an external device. So that is main is severely disabled people to communicate with humans using their electrical activity instead of their other means. And here the functionality of the brain can be interpreted through either by activity such as metabolic activity and so on. There are two, the three modes are there. It is magnetoencephalography, electroencephalography, and fMRI and NIRS. These are the non-invasive, whereas electrocorticography and intracortical neuron recording, these are comes under the invasive type. You can see the block diagram of this invasive, partial invasive, and non-invasive types. In this one, I am concentrating on non-invasive type, which is electroencephalography. Here the five stages, which is usually keep on going in the brain computer interface, that is signal processing, signal acquisition, pre-processing, or signal enhancement, feature extraction, then classification, and then the classification, whatever we have done, then we'll carry on to control interface, such as a prosthetic limb or exoskeleton device, or to operate any home appliances. One of the main application here is mentioned as exoskeleton device, prosthetic limb control, and allowing a paralyzed patient or a physically disabled person to gain motor ability PVCI controlled limb. These are the challenges which is in which at present we are facing. That is because of noisy or contained outlets, which is while taking the EEG signal. These are the mere which will suppress the actual signal which is coming out of the brain. And the different features, high dimensionality, which are present in the features, that we have to extract. For that, several channels which we are taking in the fibril from several time segments before being concatenated into a single feature vector. The main motivation to do the research in this area is the eye-blink artifacts are almost inevitable in the process of EEG data acquisition. While the subject are paralyzed or patient suffering from ALS or spinal cord injury, that eye blink movements are which are involuntary. So for that, and these signals are be shoot up because of DC shoot and frequency changes. And there are many artifacts such as filtering techniques are available, such that we can go for the further research work in this one. The objective in analyzing EEG signal to differentiate the open eye, closed eye, and eye blink by using histogram and fast Fourier transform techniques, and statistical analysis carried out to identify these eye blinks from the raw EEG signal. Our main feature object is fully dependent persons to make independent, partially independent, such as for day-to-day activities, that is connecting to exoskeleton device and prosthetic limb devices. The methodology in which the EEG headset which the subject has wear, from that the attack secretion is taken, then it is feature extracted, then it is further going for classification where we have taken this histogram and fast Fourier transform, then it is fed to the arm cortex or some device, then it is further given to the home appliances such that we can run a fan or a home operations depending upon the subject. This is the experimental modeling where the eye artifacts which I am shown here. Here we are going to take a signal from the subject on the scalp which is placed in the headset, and the eye artifacts which is constituted by the camera, such that whenever the subject is blinking the eye, which is correlated by the eye blink which has taken at the neuron shoot up, which is taken by EEG, and the eye blink captured by the camera, both are interlinked with the MATLAB, and it is further processed by some controller. Here I am used embedded controller arm cortex. Then it is a feature analysis, then it is going to the home appliances. This is the hardware and software which I have mentioned. Ultra cortex Mark IV EEG headset, which is a container of 16 channels. And the OpenBCI is the open software which is provided for capturing the data acquisition. These are the result. Histogram which I have taken, the open eye condition and blinked and also closure condition. In the open eye condition, which if you have seen this, the number of occurrences, that is 150 to 160 microvolt, which I have seen that very high, and absence of occurrence at higher amplitude. In this one, whenever the eye blink is taken place, the higher amplitude will be can be seen, where it is not present in open eye and also closed eye. It is for closed eye. Here also you can't I have marked out, as I have marked it, that is from 250 to 600 microvolt, which is not present because of there is no eye blink there. And here you can see this present of eye blink, because of eye blink, that is the more microvolts it is coming out, that we can't see in the eye blink closed and open eye condition, that we can see it here. And by this one you can see the tablet form where in that the eye blink we are getting the power of 33.8 dB, where if you compare to open eye and closed eye, it is not that much. And for it is very difficult to segregate between open eye and closed eye, whereas eye blink is can be easily segregated because of its power and also. Then I will come for conclusion. EEG is a circuit from a wireless EEG headset analyzed for detection and analyzing eye blink artifacts with the help of histogram and fast Fourier transform. Then enough evidence which I have found that while doing that, there is a further scope by using this histogram and fast Fourier, but it will be further further progress will can be taken out by wavelet transform and other advanced techniques, which can give more information about eye blink artifacts, such that very efficiently we can carry out our work. Yes, thank you.